That's her second cup. Go ahead, drink up. Go ahead.
You have to tell me twice. Drink up. You have to tell me twice.
Why are you drinking wine like that? She be trying. You ever see somebody try to be so sophisticated?
Drink like what?
Look, 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 look at my wine.
I was letting the air get to it. Because you don't want your lipsticks in this. You're so dramatic. You're so dramatic. Thank you all so much for your support in the past year. It's been amazing for us. And all because of you. Thank you for liking and subscribing and sharing and commenting.
The past seven months. We started really in May. It's been amazing.
Amazing. Been so thank you for your support and your help. And here's to a new year. Family of five, party of five. We actually got like a couple minutes to ourselves, which is surprising because that doesn't
happen.
To rest and chill and finally do the vlog. Exactly.
You know?
And that's been hard.
Got your boobs time to rest?
Boobs got some time to rest. They've been so, so sore. Mr. Kaz is a beast when it comes to eating.
I can't even get a
hug. Let me tell you that. No, I'm like, don't even come in for a head. He gets that, like, ear hug, pat on the back.
It's mad whack.
Don't come too close because...
Look at them things. Look at them things.
The situation with... exclusively breastfeeding and trying to juggle two under two... Back up.
He gets nothing.
Back up.
Cass, 1 month old, having a TBT moment.
Yes.
Throw back to the pool birth. Put into water. Right? That's why you love it in here.
It's been rough. It's been a challenge. I mean, for any mom who does breastfeeding exclusively or has nursed on demand, you know that it's literally on demand and it's whenever the baby feels like. So that's been a little hard because, you know.
And for any dad who wants their wife back, just know that breastfeeding kind of delays the process for intimacy.
Yeah.
You know?
Because it's not cute when there's.
It ain't cute.
Breast milk dripping
it's like National Geographic. Swear it's like
everywhere.
1 month old.
Watch this.
He about to be 1 month.
He don't want to hear shit. Give him the bottle. Give him the. He don't want to hear shit. Give him the bottle. Now look at him. Look, you see, he about to start swinging. Give me my bottle. Stop playing.
Sometimes I walk in here, she just got them out. They just be out walking around because she don't even want a t-shirt on them.
No, I don't. Exactly.
So, like, the kids will be asleep somewhere, and then I just walk in the door, and she's in the kitchen. And I'm like, what are you doing? And she's just like, I just need time.
Mm-hmm.
I just need time.
I don't. It's
My
rough.
My boobs need time.
It's rough. And I haven't really started pumping yet either, so I did pump a little bit to kind of get him, you know, acclimated. Well, him meaning Kaz, acclimated to the bottle.
And be acclimated.
And Val acclimated to pace
because she learned this new technique.
Yeah, it's called
Never
pace
heard
feeding.
Of it
yes,
they just
yes.
be making shit up every day. They make stuff up.
No,
for me
it
to
works
read.
For babies who are breastfed because the bottle flow is faster.
You see, you see how she changed the voice up.
Breast.
You see how she changed the voice up.
So,
it works for babies who are breastfed. Who told you this?
Takiya, my midwife. Shout out to Takiya.
You sure it wasn't Dr. Oz?
She's still in touch with me.
She's
all this time.
Shout out to Takiya. She the best.
We love you. But yeah, that's been good for.
She be watching stuff and recording him.
It's been good for making sure that the baby is not too used to that fullness and the flow of the bottle because the breast is very different.
See
so
my technique? Look,
that being said,
the arm has to be on a 37 degree angle, right? And the bottle has to be on a 64 degree angle, right? I gotta make sure that the milk doesn't fill up the whole nipple.
Yes, exactly.
Only part of the nipple, and I gotta tease my
right,
baby
but
with
but it
the
can't
milk.
Be too much air because people was coming at me for 2 seconds of air. Kaz was getting relaxed.
Well, Kaz was coming at you too.
Kaz
don't like pace feeding. Kaz be looking at me.
He's like, I know it's there. I know the milk is there. Just give me the milk.
When I see his eyes doing this.
See, watch the fist get bowled up. Watch the fist. Look, see. Oh, this milk. This milk is so good. This breast milk is so good.
Ain't it though?
Ooh, that's he's threatening you right now. Take this bottle from me one more time. One more time.
But there's a short amount of time when the babies are that small and they're breastfed that you can give them the bottle. Because some babies end up not taking the bottle at all.
Yeah.
And then the mom is not able to ever leave that baby ever. And yeah. That can't work for us. It just can't. Yeah.
Time.
We need our baby to roll with the punches. You know, exactly. Be flexible.
You gotta be flexible.
Be flexible. So these are some different techniques that I've been trying for people who have been asking.
Then she told me about she was worried about Cairo wanting to get back on
tandem.
He got teeth. How is that gonna work?
Trust me, it's the same thing I was saying. Nobody was looking forward to that. But I did hear that sometimes, and I've seen it happen, you know, in my research, that babies who are so close to just being weaned off the breast, and then you have another baby close mm-hmm. behind them, that they may want to get back on the breast, and they may want to wean to breastfeed again.
Hold on, bring it back.
So,
what is breast milk gonna do for Cairo? He eat oxtail and like whole ribs and like burgers. And like how would he even eat? Breast milk ain't gonna be nothing to him.
No, it's at that point it would be more of a comfort thing, I'm assuming, for him. Oh, I don't think it's necessarily the benefit of it.
No,
but
tandem
the thing
breastfeeding.
That was, yeah, the thing that would made me more nervous. I didn't mind if he wanted to get back on for the closeness and the comfort of it. However.
You all right, Kaz? For now. All right, we're okay for now. How's that brownie, buddy? Can always bribe Roy with food. Right? Can I have some? Can I have some? Okay, maybe not.
However, my issue is making sure my milk supply is up there. Like just before we started this, I had a whole bowl of oatmeal with flaxseed, washed it down with some water, and tried to make sure that I'm producing enough breast milk for Kaz. So that would have been my issue.
He was worried about that.
I didn't want to have to worry about Kaz getting enough milk if Cairo's drinking his milk, because you know Cairo would have went to town, and then my boob was just sore. I don't want another person on him.
I can't even imagine Cairo on the boob, because if I have a rapper.
He makes that noise now. He's like, when he sees food. I'm like, Cairo.
All kids are greedy, but Cairo is another level of greedy.
Yeah, it's so funny. I love to hear him go, Yeah, so that's been pretty interesting. But, you know, so far, so good. I've been icing my boobs whenever I need to. And, you know, Kaz has been good to me. We're getting better. It's a work in progress.
Definitely a work in progress.
What's the matter? You want me to pick you up, too? Or you want a bottle? What is that? All right, we're going to have to figure out a system here, folks. All right, Roby.
Let me tell y'all that 2 under 2 life is no joke. I've always said I never wanted to have babies that close together. But you know what? God had other plans, and we're taking it day by day. You know? It's more minute by minute.
At a loss of words. I don't even know. I don't even know. I haven't, in all honesty, I haven't slept more than 3 hours since the babies have been born. And Grandma left. Shout out to Grandma.
Grandma, we love you. And she's not even far. She's at my mom's house. We need to get her back over here.
We do. I've been asking. Don't get it twisted. I want Grandma to come back.
I know. We're just trying to share. Her birthday was a couple of days ago.
I'm not trying to share.
Roby, have a seat, Roby. You're going to fall. I have Kaz on me. Baby wearing him right now. Yes, because he was a little cranky, a little fussy, not sure why. Not sure if he had a little gas or anything. I'm still breastfeeding him solely, so it's very important for me to look at what I have in my diet sometimes to kind of make sure I'm not eating anything to upset his stomach. So yeah, he was a little fussy today, and Mr. Cairo still needs his attention, right, buddy?
Yes.
So I had to kind of strap Kaz to me so I can pick up Cairo and give him a little bit of loving. So it's been a little hard with the breastfeeding, especially. All right. With the breastfeeding, especially because, you know, I always have to have Kaz in hand for that. And I don't pump often. Every now and again, I'll pump a little bit for Deval to feed or just to get Kaz used to the bottle. So that way he's not solely reliant on me in case there's an emergency or something and I can't be with him. So Kyle's about to end this little clip here.
Y'all have no clue. Yeah. It's like I'll be at work and I'll come home and she'll have both of them. So I feel bad when I walk in the door and then let me grab Cairo. So then she'll have Kaz and Kaz is nonstop. So then the minute she goes to put Kaz down, Cairo's like, I want mommy. And then she goes and
gotta give mommy time.
Exactly. And then Kaz wakes up and I don't have no boobs. So he's screaming at me at the top of his lungs.
And then if it's ever just me and him, or me and the boys, rather, then it's just like, well, who first? Somebody gonna have to cry for a little bit. Rowan, I thought Daddy's supposed to be watching you.
Oh, gosh.
Huh? First of all, how'd you do?
It's not even funny, first of all. Because your boy, you got a runny nose. Come here.
Who has a runny nose?
Cairo.
Oh, no.
Hey.
Surviving there.
Thanks for the help, Jackson.
How was it with the first time with three kids? I left you for 20 minutes. How'd it go, Rowie? Really? Oh. Rowie has a lot to say. What?
I got a paper cut.
20 minutes. How'd it go?
I got a paper cut.
Swell.
You got a paper cut. Yeah. Rowie looked like, I don't know, he came out of Chucky. And what's going on with Kaz?
Kaz, I think, spit up.
Spit up? He never spits up. It's just about finding ways to keep everybody occupied, you know, trying to keep everybody afloat, making sure nobody's killing, you know, killing themselves or each other.
It's definitely a change.
It's different. But I think it's getting into a routine at some point. I think we will. Maybe once Kaz is a little bit older.
There's no routine right now. Yeah. Kaz wants boob, like, instantly, and his scream is relentless and it's unyielding and then sometimes I think Cairo just screams because he hears Kaz screaming and everybody runs to Kaz, so then Cairo starts screaming and then Jackson's just sitting back on his iPad
or Jackson will start making fun of Cairo sometimes. He does that now. He'll be like crying in the background. So you got three of them and it's like, Jackson, stop.
Call these two Jamaican fingers. She does this. She said, when you see this and you see the tight face, it's serious. The crying will be happening. She's like, all right. And then Jackson's like,
My thing is the one who can control the cry, stop. Like, why do you think anything is the funniest thing? He thinks it's the funniest thing. But I mean, he's six. Rowie.
You act like I ain't a pro at the game, son.
But with three of them,
I'm a pro at the game.
With three of them, I don't know.
How'd I do?
No answer.
Nothing?
They just trying to be diplomatic. It's all right. I get it. Y'all don't have to answer. I'm just glad y'all are all breathing. Nothing's broken. Kaz, I know you tell me. Tell me.
He's tell like, mommy. Whoa. Tell whoa. Mommy.
What?
Well.
Actually.
Did a good job. Right? You did a good job? I did a good job?
Nah, he was just like,
look at that smile. Yeah, I did a good job.
All right.
That's right. Daddy is the man. Oh, daddy is the man.
I guess.
Daddy is the man. Oh, daddy is the man.
Hey. Get it. All right. Get it. 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 get low.
She too nice.
Yeah.
See, the problem is she don't know how to. She don't got the dad voice.
I should just start crying too.
I've had enough of that.
If I start crying with them, they may be liable to stop crying and look at me like, oh shoot, mommy's crying now.
That's what I started doing. I started making fun of them too. I started crying.
I'm gonna try that next time.
They stop. But the funny thing is, Cairo is very smart. If I, do you know his three least favorite words in the English dictionary is have a seat. If I say have a seat, he knows I'm not playing no more games. He don't cry. He sits there. We sit there like this.
Tight. He be mad.
Eyes welling up because he want to move, but he know he can't.
Mm-hmm. It's like he want to cry, but he won't cry because he won't want to see. He don't want you to see him cry. Like, how do you even know about that already?
At 15 months, little punk.
What?
I like it, though. He's talking.
Yeah,
he's
I love Cairo. My baby. I love all my babies.
Yeah.
Team no sleep, though.
No sleep.
This guy here is a practical joker. He sleep all day. Then come 1 a.m. What are you doing up? Everybody else in the house sleep. You wide awake.
Wide awake.
Wide awake.
Every night. About midnight, he starts to kind of like wake up. Then by 1 a.m., looking around.
What? You just got to... See, what I'm trying to figure out is between Jackson, Cairo, and you, what goes on at night that y'all just got to be up? It's almost like the more quiet it gets, the more they want
to
be up.
They know daddy be trying to get some.
See, I wasn't even going to take it there, but at least she brought it out.
You know, we got to change our schedule.
I got to get some in the morning?
Yep, midday. While Jackson's at school, Cairo's napping. He's out cold.
So I'm going to make an appointment for that.
You might be on to something.
Make an appointment for that.
Mmm.
daytime booty.
Right.
Get some midday booty.
Midday booty.
Some brunch booty.
This nighttime thing ain't working out for
Look
us.
His face. Look his face. He like, nah.
He's like,
I'm going to be up then too.
No.
Yeah, you ain't with it?
No, he not feeling it. Kazzy wants to stay the baby of the family.
You gonna have some time, bro.
I don't blame him. I don't blame him.
You gonna have some time, bro.
He gonna have more than time. He gonna have his life.
I'm with Kazzy on that.
He's not amused.
I'm looking for the truth in that. I don't see it. So Christmas.
My most favorite time of the year.
Favorite time of the year, yo.
I love the holidays. It's like perfect for me because my birthday is December 5th. So I love the feeling of like summertime going into fall. Then it's like Halloween, apple picking. Then Thanksgiving, my birthday, and Christmas. That's like my favorite time of the year. It's the fall into the beginning of winter.
When she starts singing. It is.
I love it. She so festive. It.
You know why she liked it too? Presents.
Mm-hmm.
She liked getting gifts. Mm. Come on, you gotta do everything with brother, so get your brother out. Come on.
Hi, Rowie. Good morning.
Let's go. You go put him down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rowie, you gotta see if Santa came by.
Okay, Jax. He'll follow you.
Let's go, boy.
Come on, Rowie.
Did he come?
Yes.
He came.
Whoa.
What?
Whoa.
What's that?
It's alright.
Mommy, come.
I'm coming back and waiting for Romy.
Oh my gosh. Whoa. Wait, what's wrong? He ate the gingerbread and he ate half of the...
You said he was going to do that. He said he was going to eat gingerbread and half of the stocking. Wow.
And then he said, right now, since that, he said, Dear Jackson, thank you for the brownies and milk. Continue to be respectful to your mom and dad. Always protect Cairo and Kaz. I don't know what that says.
Let me see. Handwriting is kind of crazy.
Mm-hmm.
It says read. That's R-E-A-D.
See, it's a penmanship kind of.
Read.
It's work.
It says read.
Read more books and always try to be first in life. Eat your vegetables and your protein. Oh. Work hard at the gym and drink a lot of water. See you next year, person.
Oh, good nice. Job, man.
Like he knows you, Jax. Roey, what you got?
And we do Santa in the house. Some people debate online, is there going to be a Santa or not?
Yeah.
We do Santa in the house. It's fun. You know what I mean? I think people take it too seriously sometimes.
People take everything too seriously.
You know, like, relax.
And it's like they're taking the fun away from everything. I had Jackson came to me this year. Daddy, is Santa real?
It starts already.
And I was like, yo, you're six. Like, how do you even...
Once they get to school.
And I said, I don't know why. He was like, somebody said it's not real. I said, who? He said... Christopher. I said, he's a middle school kid? No, he's a second grader.
He's seven. Second graders.
So I was like, oh. I said, what'd he say?
First.
He said, Santa's not real. Is Santa real? So at this point, I had to kind of reflect, and I'm like, all right, do I lie to my son and say that Santa is real?
Tell a fib. Fib's better.
Do I fib? Or do I tell the truth and kind of break his spirit? And I'm like, you know what? I'm going to choose to keep my son innocent and keep the spirit going. So what I said was not necessarily a lie. I said, you know what?
Mm-hmm. If you believe
in Santa, then he'll come. If you don't believe, then you don't get anything. So he was like, yeah, I believe then, because I got a list of stuff that if I don't believe, I ain't get nothing. I believe in it.
He believes in it.
So I told him, I said, well, if you believe in Santa, you have to believe in doing good. Because even if you believe in Santa, if you don't do good, you won't get anything.
Mm-hmm. There we go. Just like that.
Mm-hmm. This is typical of every Christmas. You get a kid a bunch of toys. Hey, he want to play with the nose. Tissue and the
I
boxes.
Mean, at least use a tissue. Jackson.
Right? Jackson. Oh, you wiping your nose, bro? All right, go ahead. There you go.
Use a tissue.
Right? Yeah. You
got ready to
Yeah.
Daddy.
You got to blow your nose, buddy?
Daddy. I got Lightning McQueen.
Let me see.
Oh!
Wow!
That
open.
Oh! That was pretty dumb.
What you open it, Jackson?
I got Jackson Storm!
Oh!
I got... Yes! Jackson Storm!
He took it away, bro.
Wait!
Whoa!
Look at the
get it! Get it!
Oh
yes!
My God.
Oh, this is
nice.
Okay.
Yes!
This is nice, Nana. And Papa,
I ain't that smooth.
Thank you. This is smooth. I wonder, he won't fit into it by next
time. I know, but it's
you still going under the tree, Ma?
Yeah. Yeah, oh, cool.
How much more is under there?
A lot.
Oh, no.
How much more is under there?
Look.
I got Lightning McQueen, though.
You still open this stuff?
Yeah.
Who got you all this stuff? Who got you all this stuff?
Yes!
Wow.
Nice.
And the Jackson Storm.
Yo!
Kaz, you lit too, boy.
Oh, Kaz yeah. Lit, buddy. Kaz lit, boy.
You got the Duracell to buy?
You know I got the Duracell. You know I got the Duracell, school. Always got the Duracell.
This is the Cairo.
Keep going and going.
Okay, buddy. Run Christmas at my parents' house. So what? Get it. Mom and Grandma in the kitchen chefing it up. Whoa! You think your presence
December
is my present?
December 20th.
Not all the time.
Try to take a shot at me, son.
I'm just saying, I get your presents all the time. I want presents, tangible presents.
Oh, gosh.
I gave you the most tangible present of them all this year.
What's that?
A whole son. A whole baby.
As opposed
to...
Not
a half. Not three quarters.
You got that. You got that.
Not a quarter. A whole human being.
And I got you, son.
It's all about love.
I got you, son. I got you. You gave me three little mini versions of myself.
I did. Sure did.
Champion.
Ride with the mob, hamdu Allah, check in with me, and do your job. Berg is the name, big ballers in the chain, Tolo from the watch, Prezi playing Jane. That's a piece of muscle.
Hey, hit it, hey, watch that footwork, watch that footwork, watch that footwork, hey. your balance. Get your balance. Get your balance. Yes. Get your balance. Hey. Watch their footwork. Hey. Watch their footwork. Hey. Creep down the stairs and then go back right away. Hey. 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 Oh. Get in. Get in. Lick him. Get in. Get in. Lick him. Ah. Ah. Hit the thriller. Hey. Hit the thriller. Hey. Hit the thriller. Hey. Hit the thriller. Michael Jackson. Hey. Jackson, hey, Jamaican Michael Jackson, hey.
You gotta tell him real quick about your brother, though, when he didn't believe in Santa anymore, but he kept it going.
So, my brother's 13 years old, right? 13 years old.
13.
And I'm 16 at the time, and I'm like, yo, my guy, why are you asking to call Santa? Like, what the fuck is wrong with you, son? And he was just like, look, let me tell you something, all right? If I ask mommy and daddy for a gift, I get it. If I ask Santa for a gift, I get that too.
Smart.
So I get two things. Mm-hmm. You over here being no super macho know-it-all talking about you don't believe in Santa. That's why you only get one thing. Mm-hmm. So I was like,
facts.
Damn, he's right. Let's go call Santa.
At 16.
Santa, I had a hat on. You're not gonna be here.
No.
What's your plan?
I got nothing to do with that.
My kids
gonna
be here. I'm gonna
be
in Canarsie, so. Oh, so you have to have the house by yourself?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
That's why you said what?
Make sure you ring the doorbell when you call. What?
I'm gonna play my PlayStation.
Sorry.
See?
Y'all, you gotta stop.
What?
Now y'all see where I get it from, right? I get it from here.
Y'all have a PlayStation. I don't have a PlayStation. Maybe y'all get me a PlayStation.
All right. I'm buying you a PlayStation. You heard that? Your papa scooped you the PlayStation.
Yeah, we. All right. It's things. It's things.
Come on. I'll get you a PlayStation, though. You can leave my mother alone, all right?
Things.
Things.
Oh, God.
Hey. I'm out, Mom. Love y'all.
I remember going in there and get them socks that morning to school.
No!
They went to school with one sock on their head.
She's still excited about it.
I'm out of here.
Hey, things!
Good night. Things! What's this things?
When's this call? Or when's this season?
No, I ain't gonna see Santa. I'm not sitting on a grown-ass man's lap, son. Get out of here, son. Ooh, call Santa on the phone. Say, yo, Santa was good. Need some Tims. Need an A-Rex jacket. You know?
All the pricey items.
Need a PlayStation 2. I've been good. Got an 85 average. Make mm-hmm. that happen. Holler at your boy. Mm-hmm. Click.
You can't say the words I want to hear while you're with another man.
Do you want
the answer yes or no?
Put
your sweet lips a little closer to the phone.
I ain't never heard this song ever in my life.
Let's pretend that we're together all alone.
I'll tell the man
Jim Reeves.
To turn the
you never heard this, Roe?
Your friends are waiting.
You have to go.
Yes! Back to Christmas. I had one thing on my list this year, and I didn't get it.
What was that?
I'm feeling some kind of way about it.
This is the first time I hear about this. What you didn't get?
Well, the one thing that I wanted to
do. You're doing the mouth pop. Oh, what does that mean?
Was to take one of my placenta pills.
Oh!
And he did not.
Oh!
So my Christmas was not made. DeVal, you said you were going to take one of my pills. So yes, I got my placenta encapsulated. I did.
Who does that?
I did. After researching it much and speaking with my midwife and a couple women who have done it before about their experience, I decided to do it. What? It's mine. It's mine. I did it. I am taking it. So what? So you know how your boy would not get in the placenta water, right? So the deal we had was that if I was to change my placenta into capsules, which I did, yes, don't throw shade.
Who made that deal?
Google it.
What do you mean?
You're lying. Look at how your son is looking right now. You're lying.
It's time to pay the piper, bro.
I never agreed to that.
It's time to pay the piper. You see how Kaz is looking at you? Like, set an example and
it's because you're bullying me.
You're bullying me. Put it in your mouth and swallow it, bro.
Pause. You're bullying me.
Ain't nobody bullying you. Pay up, bro. Pay up.
And why are you talking like Rico with paid in full?
I only had three boys for you. Three whole boys.
All right.
Swallow it.
All right.
We waiting.
Oh, God.
You did not.
I'm pregnant. Now I'm pregnant. I got placenta in me.
Kaz, your father's full of shit.
And I'm burping up placenta.
Mad dramatic.
First of all.
The benefits of it.
There are benefits.
There are lots of benefits to it.
For helping you.
To balancing hormones.
Not for me. I don't need none of them hormones breast in my life. Supply. I'm already too emotional.
You emotional?
I don't need any more of them hormones.
Whatever.
I don't.
No, you don't. You need a little estrogen to tame you down. So
why you want me to take a pill?
Take
like, I ain't doing
up.
That, son.
No, it was just a joke. It was a joke, and
first
it was supposed to be funny, and it was supposed to be fun, and he definitely did not take the pill.
Hell no, I ain't take that pill.
You
first of all,
so
Takiya told us, first of all, I asked, so how do they do the pills? They said, well, they take the placenta, they dry it out.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, dry it out where? They said, in your oven. I said, you're not putting my wife's placenta in my own oven, bro. I eat out of there.
He's like, my food gets cooked there.
Facts.
If there was going to be like placenta remnants in there. You know,
there will be. The placenta ashes go up in the oven and it stays there. And then the rest of your food got the placenta scent. And I told you
that
before,
so
I have
true.
A phobia of placenta. I'm clinically diagnosed with placenta phobia.
Who diagnosed you? Placentaphobia?
Dr. Oz dies. Placentaphobia, I got that.
You're so
I see placenta and a hork.
For the record, he was actually going to get into the water with me when I had Kaz sidebar. I just didn't want him in there at that point because I was in so much pain. I was just like, don't come in here and touch me. Don't interfere with my space. Stay out there in your personal space. I'm going to stay in mine. So don't act like you weren't gonna get in the water, cause you were.
Nah, if you were struggling, mm-hmm. I would have got in.
I mean, I was struggling. Don't get it wrong.
I was struggling, and I prayed. I prayed on it. God said, "Got you." God said, "He got you."
Mm-hmm.
He said, "Keep your eyes on Him, child. For he who sits in thy placenta water doesn't need another man in thy placenta water." So I didn't have to be there.
Anyway, I didn't want him in the water, so he wasn't
Amen.
In the water. Okay,
Amen.
So he got out on that.
Thank
but I was
you.
Like, at least you could do is just take one pill as a dare. And he didn't do it. So, oh well.
What's up, baby?
Damn. How was the gym?
Good.
Yeah?
I got all PRs, all because of you.
Oh, what do you mean because of me?
Because of you, because I'm backed up. I was on the treadmill hitting it.
Okay, I thought he was hitting
20, hitting
get it. Get it.
On the bench, too.
Yes.
315.
Yes. How much weight?
All the way. This is how much weight
yes.
I said all the way. Put
all
more
right.
weight on.
Get it.
Straight beasted.
All right.
I hope you're ready. Because when I come, I'm coming with the thunder. This 6 weeks, I'm coming with
and
the thunder.
And rain.
I'm coming with the rain, too.
All right. Just don't bring up on me because I don't need those kind of problems
I'm
on
prepared
my head
for that. I'm prepared for that. Watch
no.
this. I've been working on the quickness. See, you be liking it here, right? You be liking it here. Watch this. I'm out. You see that? See
okay.
how I'm out? Hold on.
Right.
Show me. One time.
Wait.
See, I know you like this right here. You know how you like the leg up?
Right.
The leg up, we be here. I'm out.
Did you just push me in my face?
See, I mushed you because I'm out. I'm ready.
Oh, my God.
I'm ready. See, okay. I'm ready. I'm not playing no games. See that? I'm not playing no
oh
games.
Oh, my God.
You better be ready.
All right. Well, maybe I am.
Don't play with me. I'm ready right now. Don't you play with me.
I have to say, I've been taking my placenta pills, and they've been good.
Got energy.
I do have energy. I'm not sure if that's a combination of sleeping a little bit more while Kaz sleeps at night.
When
you know,
sleep more.
Nursing on them. Sure, I don't sleep more. I'm lying. It's the placenta pills. It got me.
Either that or delirium.
It has to be. Yeah, that too.
Because you
that's
you
definitely.
Just...
I'm a little crazy. But I'm holding it together. I'm holding it together, folks. Breast milk supply boost. I don't know if I've seen that much of a boost in mine yet. I just don't think that I'm like a big overproducer like that. I'm getting by. We're getting by. So pray for me on that one.
And Kaz is gaining weight, so you
yeah,
good.
Yeah, Kaz is gaining weight. He's peeing and he's pooping like he should.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that's always a good sign to tell if the baby's eating or not. And what were some of the other benefits? Just balancing out your hormones, you know, trying to make sure that
she has been in a better mood
after. So
she has been in a better mood.
I have been. It helps with postpartum depression if that's ever an issue or a concern. Yeah, and I've been feeling great this time around. I might have had a little of that with Cairo. I think we told you guys that in the last vlog. So yeah, I've been in pretty good spirits. I can't complain too much. And you think I'd feel worse at this point, you know, being so overwhelmed with 3 babies now, or 3 kids.
She's good.
Rather,
she's doing well. We at 5.5 weeks, about to be 6 weeks. So you know what that means.
I made my appointment. I spoke to Takiya, our midwife, yesterday, to touch base about
who's touching base.
About who can touch
I'm
base
trying to get
soon.
The first base. First base.
So I spoke to her, and we have my appointment scheduled for next Saturday. So. How are we going to get rid of the kids for the weekend?
I will take them anywhere you want them to go.
Anywhere?
I will drive them through this blizzard right now.
What?
Mm. I'll take them anywhere. Either that or I'll lock them in a room. Yes. I'll make it soundproof.
Yes.
In 30 minutes, you mine. I don't care.
You sure 30 minutes, though? It's been a while.
30 minutes.
30 minutes?
Talk about placenta pills. I'm going to take a pill.
You can guarantee me.
I'm going to take a pill.
Oh, at that point.
I guarantee it's going to be at least 30 minutes.
Oh, shoot.
Mm-hmm. Either that or your father's rum punch.
I'm scared. Oh, no.
Thanks, Pops.
Not the rum punch. Not the rum punch.
Yes.
You're so